You are watching Oblivion commentary from Shona Films.
This is the Mehrun Razor quest thing, and for some reason it fell on the ground. Let's try this again. Come on, Havoc. Do your magic. Okay, there we go. That's how it's supposed to be. Oh! Who's that? Okay, it won't let me grab it. I have to walk into it like an old Quake 2 game? Okay, let's try this again. We're gonna walk into it like I'm playing Quake 2. I still can't grab it. Okay, just walk into it. All the time. That is so weird. Playing Half-Life now. I'm just gonna walk into it. Oh, that's so lame. This is a homage to games that ran on IPX, LAN parties, that sort of thing. It's reading zero ping, man! Zero ping! Okay. So I have the razor from Skyrim. It's in Oblivion. I got it. Something about, uh-oh. It's a good thing we weren't staying there, I suppose. Yeah, apparently with this knife, you can you have like a 25% chance of killing somebody. I didn't want to waste its enchantment, so I'm just using a sword for now. That was a long ass crazy quest getting that razor. I went on UESP and it says that fort is the largest dungeon in Oblivion. It's got the most levels. And they're not joking. It was pretty huge compared to your average dungeon in Oblivion. What? Why won't you die? So, a few days ago when I fired this old game up after 2 years of not playing it, I thought, this is gonna be lame. Because I'm used to Skyrim. You know, Skyrim with 800 mods installed. And I come back to Oblivion, I'm like, But you know what? After just a couple days of playing Oblivion, I'm hooked. I am so hooked on this game now. I'm not even noticing how lame it is. Okay, now I got the razor in my hand. Woohoo! Looks almost like the one in Skyrim. Almost.
Pardon me for asking, but are you sure that you know where we are going?
So last night I went on the YouTubes, looked up people's videos on Vilya from Oblivion, and theirs all look different from mine.
This place is creepy.
So mine must be modded.
Talk later.
I had this great idea that I was just going to go in here and grab an artifact that a merchant needs me to recover for him. And he said it was in this dungeon, so I headed over here. And apparently, gotta be like level 12 or 15 to even be in this place. I think I'm level 7. 6 or 7. I was getting my ass handed to me. Just... I'll come back here in about 10 levels. Oh, there goes Velia. She got knocked off the... She got knocked off the thing. Whoa! Trapdoor. See? Like, this guy has no armor. My sword's doing nothing against him. So I push the button, right? And he sneaks up. He or someone else. Yeah, I see. He sneaks over there and he pushes the button. Did you see that? It looked like he pushed the button after I pushed it. Anyway, I found out later the reason why I was getting my ass kicked is because my armor's damaged and my weapons are damaged, which I didn't know. I forgot that in Oblivion that happens. Because, like, I have armor on, why am I getting killed? And, yeah, it's like my armor was down to, like, one piece of armor, one point of armor left on my armor. Instead of, you know, 100%. Yeah, instead of it being 100% armor, it's only 1% armor. So, we'll go there another time. But yeah, my Velia's modded, so that's why she looks way different than everyone else's. But yeah, the graphics are kind of hokey and stuff, but I don't know. I'm more interested in the quest I have to do.
Wouldn't it be nice to just talk a little, you and I?
You know, these games are quest-driven.
There should be some kind of security block on scrolls. Once I activated one by accident, lightning bolts can be really devastating inside a shop. Goodbye.
And the more quests you have in your journal, of course, the more you're going to want to stay in the game doing those quests to see how things work out. And exploration, you know, it's been so long since I've played Oblivion. I don't remember what, you know, every square inch has in it. Like Skyrim, I played Skyrim forever, right? So I know every square inch of Skyrim. Pretty much. So there's no new places to explore in my Skyrim. But in Oblivion, I find stuff like this, and it's like, oh, I get a Daedric weapon. Woohoo! And up in the top right corner, it's got a little timer going on for my helmet and for my bow. But I don't have any arrows. Do I have to click on arrows before I can use this bow? I don't remember. Do I need Daedric bows to use the bow? Look at that helmet. That's so cool. Velia is not impressed. And then this stuff like this, it says, okay, now you have to go back to a temple to to get the actual blessing. What? That's crazy. What mechanic is this? Meanwhile, I went to this lady's house. She has a rat problem. Rats have invaded her house.
Oh, my poor little rats!
Ah, you must be from the Fighters Guild. Good, I have a problem. It has to do with the rats in my basement.
That's right. Rats in my basement, and something has been killing them. It's horrible. My poor babies. You must do something.
What is...
I don't know what I'd do without them.
She sounds like a cartoon character.
Noses, their scaly little tails. Please get to the basement and find out what's happening. Please save my little rats.
It's weird how I remember these quests from, like, you know, 12 or 13 years ago. Oh, how many years would it be? This game came out in 2006. Yeah, I guess... Yeah, it's... It was a while ago. See, I don't remember mountain lions in the quest. I just remember she had rats, is all. They have mountain lions in this game? I'm guessing it's not a mod. So then it is sort of true. Skyrim has prehistoric animals, and Cyrodiil has contemporary animals in its game. No prehistoric?
Well, what have you found? Did you take care of my babies? What was going on down there? A mountain lion? In my basement? But how? That's not possible, but it happened. What if there are more? What if it wasn't alone? Where there's one, there will be more. Find Pinaris and Ventius. He's a hunter and knows this area inside and out. He'll know what to do. Please, go find Pinaris and those mountain lions.
So while I was looking at other people's videos to see what their villas look like, I noticed that all their NPCs were hideous looking.
Can I help you in any way?
So I'd forgotten how bad NPCs look in Oblivion. Just the worst artists you can possibly hire did the modeling and stuff on these people.
Wouldn't it be nice to... I never forget the first potion I made. It was supposed to restore health, but my father almost died of it. Of course. Maybe this would be a good time to repair our armor.
So then I was thinking, well, Bethesda has a long history of making ugly-ass NPCs. So I'm just gonna assume that Elder Scrolls 6 is going to carry on that tradition and just have the most god-ugly people you've ever met as
yes?
NPCs.
Goodbye.
Hmm. And I want to say their poses and animations are going to be just as bad, as always. Yeah, and for Morrowind, Oblivion, and Skyrim, I have sitting animations. Just animations that make NPCs sit down. I have to have that. I have to have a mod to get NPCs to sit like normal people. Because Bethesda doesn't know how to make people sit in a chair.
Mountain lions? Here. Odd. If they're around, I can find them. Come with me. A hunt will do us good and maybe make that old nut feel better. Let's go hunting.
Yeah, I totally don't remember any of this. Come on. Pathfind your way down here. You can do it. Let's just go. We'll just go. Hopefully he'll... Oh, where is he? What, he went out the back door? Is he one of those guys? I don't know how to get out of my house, so I just go out the emergency exit. Yeah, he went out the back way. Alrighty then. Oh, is this gonna take forever? We're gonna walk to this place? Okay, I'll play your little game. Maybe there was a fast travel outdoors, and I can just meet him there.
Ooh, I'm saving up enough for some medicine.
Yeah. Let's get you some medicines.
Blessings of Stendhal.
My beggars are patched, so their voices don't change in mid-sentence. That was so annoying. Okay. That would be cool if he got on his horse and he'd ride off, and then I'd get on my horse and ride off, and we'd be on our horses riding to this fabled Lion King village area that we're supposed to go on a murder spree, killing all the mountain lions. Apparently, if I remember right, the mountain lions are just here.
If they're out here, they'll be in this area. I can't imagine there are more than four of them. Let's take care of this.
He is all for extinction of other things.
I think that'll be all of them. Can't imagine more in this area. You can go tell Arvena this is all taken care of. Good hunting.
Guess what? I have found one of the ingredients I was looking for.
Yay.
Isn't that great?
You're taking forever to find these ingredients.
Yes. You do want to... Not really. I can wait until we get indoors. That's fine with me. Sure. Anything in particular you have in mind? Oh well, whatever. Glad that you understand that I can handle this on my own without you interfering.
Oh, and then another thing I noticed when I was watching other people's Oblivion videos is that they have the old crappy GUI. It looks like 640 by 480. With big giant blocky fonts. It's like, oh man. Shoot me if I ever play Oblivion in that mode again. I think the mod I'm using is the Darnified UI, and it makes the fonts nice and small, and you know, all the GUI stuff is small on the screen instead of cluttering up the screen. Maybe she's upstairs still? Yep.
You've got to take care of those mountain lions! You think you've gotten rid of them all? You do? Well, you haven't! There's one in my basement right now! Go get it!
What? Is this one of those O. Henry novels where the guy gets eaten by a lion? Well, at least the rats aren't trying to kill me. Oh, nice help, Vilya. Who keeps closing this door?
Like the gods, you killed that thing. This is ridiculous. Someone's out to get me, to get my poor babies. I'll bet it's that quill weave next door. She's the one. She's never liked me or my sweet little pets. I know it's her. I've even seen her sneaking around in back of my house at night. She thinks she's so smart. She and all the other women. I'll show her. I want you to keep an eye on her. Find out what she's up to. Please save my little rats.
Out in the wilderness. Almost any creature you find is liable to give you a disease.
What are those things called that attics, or not attics, basements have? Is it called egress? Like an emergency escape from a basement? That's what her basement has now, and apparently mountain lions are using the egress to enter the basement.
My name's Quillweave. I've had some success selling stories about the lives of the lower and criminal classes. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not sure what you're accusing me of, but don't do it without any proof. I don't know what you're... Let's get to training.
She'll train me still, that's funny.
Take care.
Take care. I accused her of something and she's all, take care. While I'm here, is there anything I can read? You have any cool books to learn from? So I had this great plan that I was going to follow her and see what she's up to. And yeah, for like 30 minutes, she fiddle-farted around.
Didier Ormeley, a ship's clerk. At present, I'm spending my time and gold on the pleasures of the Gold Coast.
So that was some of the video I deleted last night on purpose, but I also deleted a bunch of other videos last night, not on purpose, or accidentally on purpose, and I'll blame that NPC for that happening. This is like 30 minutes of footage wasted. Waiting for her to make her move so I can say, aha! So you are doing something with mountain lions. So I came back here the next night, and sure enough, she was in the backyard doing all kinds of stuff. Like a crazy person. But yeah, so I deleted that footage, but then I had my trigger finger deleted a bunch of other files I still needed to upload to YouTube. Oh well. Because I had my Oblivion files and my Skyrim files mixed together in the same folder, which I shouldn't be doing. It's not helping that she's got the sexy move and she's walking all slow everywhere she goes. Anyway, next video.